Hold on. locomotive here.
Thank you.
but the owner of a rusty pickup truck with a license plate reading G00.
Guess what, all you super spies? It's showtime! And here's the Grand Times leading that parade of party timers, Chuck E. Cheese and the band.
Yo, the Rocket Dude here. This is the coolest part of the show, because it was written for me. I was having this totally bummer day about a week ago. I was completely bummed because I couldn't go surfing because his teacher was making me learn all the state capitals. And then, my dad told me to clean the garage. Bogus! So, Chucky wrote this song for me. It's excellent. Listen.
6 hours of school and a day's a long way from through. When I get home...
celebrating Jasper's birthday. That's right, our loyal bass playing hound dog who is all about friendship. Sing with us now as we wish Jasper T. Jowls a happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Well, you coming?
Where?
Why, to the North Pole, of course! This is the Polar Express!
The North Pole? Detector mile post 0.0. Detector milepost 0.0. No defects. Total axles 6.8. Train speed 2.5 mph. Detector out. We'll be right back.
the AT and the SF Engine 2926. It has a lot of history behind it, from being a war baby, to its withdrawal from service, to its current restoration. Work is being done to return it to steam. To better understand the significance of the engine, we must understand the history of railroads in New Mexico.
A lot of people don't realize how important the railways were to not just New Mexico's history, but the nation's history. The railroads were the United States' first major industry. Just a few years after the first tracks were laid in the United States back in the 1840s, we already had the largest railroad network in the world. It expanded that quickly.
The railroad first came into the New Mexico territory in December of 1879 in Santa Fe, won a race with Denver and Rio Grande and got the tracks over Raton Pass first. It built very quickly. Railroads played a critical part in opening up the state, of course then it was the territory, to the rest of the country, and opening up the opportunities for mercantile activities from New Mexico to the rest of the country.
We were nothing until the Santa Fe Railroad came over Raton. We were a couple of dusty hamlets on the Camino de Arroyo. We had so little. And when the Santa Fe got here, you know, it's everything changed.
The Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe Railroad, or Santa Fe, or ATNSF for short, ran from California to Illinois. From its first days, it primarily used steam power. However, this would change in the 1940s and 50s when diesel engines were introduced, diesels outclassed steam engines being more advanced. This caused many railroads to stop producing steam engines. However, when the United States entered World War II, things would be different for the Santa Fe.
The Santa Fe Railroad went to the War Production Board and asked them for more diesel locomotives during the war. They were, of course, told that they couldn't have diesel engines because they needed them from submarines and other things. So that the War Production Board told the Santa Fe Railroad, if you want more motive power, it has to be steam.
And so, the 2900 series was created. First put to use in 1943 and 1944, these oil-burning engines ran from Kansas to California, with the 2926 being one of them. This was a huge engine too, being almost 120 feet long and weighing over 250 tons.
This steam locomotive was one of the top-of-the-line steam locomotives that ran here. It ran over a million miles, carrying passengers, freight, and military traffic, and so it played a critical role in New Mexico's history.
Like the rest of its class, the 2926 held high-speed trains during its run. And keep in mind, this was the time before the interstate and commercial air travel. In December 1953, engine 2926 was withdrawn from service, as were the rest of the 2900 engines. Of the 30 that were built, only 6 survive today. In October 1956, the 2926 was donated to Coronado Park in Albuquerque, New Mexico, where it stood on display for many years.
Everyone remembers this engine. This was the steam engine in the park. This was the train in the park. This was history when it wasn't making history.
In the 1990s, a nonprofit organization called the New Mexico Steam Railway and Railroad Historical Society took interest in the 2926.
Starting the project because it was some old men talking. And it was in the late 90s, and gosh, wouldn't it be great if we got together and had a group and we could buy that locomotive out of the city park, and then we could fix it up and run it. And so it was kind of, it was beer talk, it was coffee talk. It wasn't deadly serious talk. In about 1998, we had bought the locomotive from the city, and then it was like game on.
On June 23rd, 2000, the 2926 was moved from the park. With the help of cranes, portable tracks, and a couple of diesel engines, the engine was moved to its current home along 8th Street in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Upon its arrival, some members of the NMSL and RHS were surprised at what they had gotten into.
If you were to walk on this site, oh, 5, 6, 7 years ago, and you encountered a fair number of our members and everything, and if you ask them a question, and if they were honest, more than a few would say, we're not so sure this is going to succeed. You know, this looks so formidable, and there's so much to do, and so, you know, and money to raise and everything. And there were some doubting Thomases, some folks that just didn't think we were going to make it.
To make things easier, the restoration process began with the engine's tender, where its fuel is stored.
We started the tender thinking, this will be a good warm-up for the real job, which is the locomotive. It was a little more complicated than we figured. We thought, you know, maybe a year, shouldn't take much longer.
We finished the tender, and the tender was all nice and shiny and spiffy, and we all stood back and said, hey, you know, we can do this. And we started on the engine. As we evolved with work on the engine, you know, we got the asbestos removed, which was a big deal. And things like that, major accomplishments. All of a sudden, people's attitudes started changing. And it became a matter of not if, but when.
With all this progress thus far, the restoration of the 2926 looks very optimistic. The NMSL and RHS have great plans for the future.
They're seriously looking at next year. I know I tell my wife that. She goes, you've been telling me that for 10 years, but next year looks very positive.
I plan to redo the lettering on the locomotive and the tender and make it look authentic like it did in Taffy Day.
I want to sell you a ticket. I want to take you for an excursion behind a steam locomotive through the American Southwest.
The main plan right now is to go from here to Las Vegas, New Mexico. The general idea is to run excursions there and back.
Eventually, we'd like to operate farther afield. Theoretically, we could go anywhere there's standard gauge rails. For practical purposes, we'd be thrilled to go anywhere they'll let us come.
You know, it would be a big draw for Albuquerque as far as bringing in tourism.
I want to see this big engine run, and it'll bring back a lot of boyhood memories.
It is a living, breathing part of the industrial history of our country. I think that's worth saving.
It's been declared New Mexico's steam locomotive by the legislature, and I just think this is a marvelous project. In addition to having people donate money, we'd love to have people come down and help us work, or just come down and visit us.
It's my history, it's your history, it's everyone's history, it's American history.
And hopefully, within another year, the NMSL and RHS will be selling tickets to ride with the 2926, and the engine will be under steam once more.
It's an historical icon.
Este es el océano.
The 2926 steam locomotive. It was originally a passenger locomotive from 1944 to 1953, bringing people between Los Angeles and Chicago at the stop.
You
want to
see it?
Hundreds of volunteers have been working to restore it since 1949.
15 years ago, we said, well, we'll be done in 6 years. 14 years ago, we said, well, we'll be done in 6 years. Now we're about to, we'll be done in a year point.
1 year may sound familiar, but many of these volunteers have been waiting for this milestone for 20 years. That's why it's active even more in 2012 when thieves broke through the fence and stole some of the train's parts. It was caught on surveillance video. The group of burglars stripped the iron horse. Volunteers say it set them back about $10,000 in material costs.
There's no locomotive parts store. If you want a piece, you gotta make one from scratch.
It took volunteers about a year just to rebuild the pieces that were stolen.
This is a dedicated year after year after year struggle, and we're winning.
He anticipates being able to make steam in the boilers later this year, which hasn't happened since 1953. After testing all of the locomotive's appliances, they will put on pistons and valves so it can move on its own power. Then you'll finally be able to go for a ride. Justin Matthews, KOAT Action 7 News.
Now here.